Boethius, Gerald Manley Hopkins, and of course Jeff Nuttall. Like Bill, very much an anarchist with a capital or lowercase a as you like. The poem is it's quite intricate for Bill at this late date, and I think it's extraordinary. I hope I get through it. It has a little epigraph from Jeff's book, Bomb Culture. Both connive. Both connive at their tacit mutual business, which is world destruction. A curved eagle, a bathed brim of tape, and cloth-armed, tin, enamelled, plasma-beaked. All Austria to US, I see no sign of. Carries itself on, every riot. Hell of dog kick, arm, machine, muscle to move, bulk of bicep. Here, cage leg like broken in exercise, all opens, brave, taut at back. Dark grass flail pole, striped, a procession, mask of skull, spear of glove, hanging at high hands is to chin up, I choose, to float, folded ankles. To pose the hot springing sun's day, unbanked, whispered, as a blast tube of horn and skywall. Knuckle flute bird, declares, twists, sings, prisons, riots, smokes, upping lofty looking spirals. Hodie vire ut milites totum carcarum tartari luce causant pererunt. How the gloss, high black engine, all carriages, parts, verbs full. Or dispersed each legason, round, overboard, light, a dance, silsold of its work. Lime tremendous, the head. Centurial no more, disachieved, such it's that was, Alice. The fist, mutile, future, at play with wars, passes, improvements, no hidden shielded squad in the street, each cobble with muscle, stone rain, flying, photo entries, rubbish money, the sinister, matchless magic of curling guts, unwinds, melody, sweats the stream, abrades its beat, rubs the royal scent, single fibre, or dead butterfly, the broken, slur-mouthed Linda budges in her heather-whipped room. Rings and ears, breasts and femur, all will one day coordinate a just body, a bone cap, a pleasure to be. And pure vanity makes me want to read this one because I publish it. Small part of making it happen. I did a book for the 100th anniversary of Rambo and asked Bill if he would contribute, and he did this, which is called Les Assis after Rambo, and as you would expect, the film is quite a long way after. I thought it would be in the French along, but it doesn't actually help. So. Les Assis after Rambo. It's in two columns, or thick column and thin column. Men to be mole dark, placard skull. Rough bright beaches of fungi. We echo and stand. Some oceanic fantasy of limb sticks, bones, tokens of twist to run. Special, dim, brittle. What else to sit perking skin before the vitreous symbols intending? Winter withstand. And the chairs grow, being wood and sun, wheat and light, all intertwined. Sooner, sun symbol. Crouch, play, drum, like clapping songs, all null love. Symbol and issue. Don't do it, they are cats awake, willful and hombrous, full inflate. Rise. To be watched. Bald, black, with form buttons, lighthouse sharp, deliberate with colour. And this is from a little poem. It's a little poem that comes in a collection of other poems. It's not really part of the sequence, but it very much, to my mind, is an offshoot of the Book of Ode, particularly the On Land section, or the rabbit hunt, which is this hand in the net and attempt at putting something on dry land, this thing. The same expedition that Robert told us about. So this is hunting rabbits at the junction of the Slough Arm. At the start, why not at the start? This is rabbits. Peregrine call ears, voyants and woody tail tubs. You could have, from the curtains of the sward, guessed it, I suppose. Right? Half night still, sultan's story pours the throat, murk straw, and the logs in rot, and these are all dance life, stink tufts, body to body, greasy padded. No, a little joy, lap-legged, warbling, hatted spirits pursuing the sometimes over balances, beams, limping. There's a passage in the prose story of the rabbit hunt, and Bill suggests that they would have had more success if they nailed the lettuce to the ground and waited.
As the text proves.
I had wanted to read After the Cold, and I'm glad I did, because I'm happy I heard other people do it. But I wanted to read something that gave Bill's rather ferocious politics clarity. And this is actually quite tame, but it's quite powerfully satirical. It's a play about the abolition of the GLC. The GLC abolished. It's prose and little verse intersections. The GLC abolished. Time to wake up again, the usual bears at the window. Could the daylight too be growing? The solemn morning, the monster goats stir in the outfields. And in the day again, past the window, warm, and in the light, plant down shifts and stirs. I'm thinking of small things as I take breakfast, like any other day, suddenly to stop, as though I've forgotten why I should be uneasy, or what sorts of foolery are afoot with the smell of discord. On the hills, the wolves and foxes lie down and discuss what more the government can possibly do for them. It is as though something is taken away from you, and the thief returns to punish you for carelessly losing it. What can you say? Yet there is something more than just grotesque about this day. It is self-defeating. The mouth of a dragon twists to bite its own tail. For today, the government will make a city disappear. No more London, not even a shire take its place. I open the windows of my friend's flat to watch the transformation, uncertain what is happening. Exhilarating, over the plants. Mountain range, in the width of windows viewing the warm brick sides of the mountains. There, the houses are folded and waved in a complex of mountains. The wall that is faces of houses is plain and square, such brick the new mountain building. Curves, keystone, brick arches, and imagine something more complex. Burning oxygen, it lives as fast as a fire and grows great. It uses up everything around it to make it, to interrupt, disturb, to be stable, immense, but it cannot be right. It can only build memory, think, and plan ways out. In our new evolutionary science, decisions would be made as to life direction and genetically legislated. One of the new formats will attain the ability to quiz the universe as to what it wants of us. Whether it wishes to be packed away in its box or expand to an equivalent of nothing or to be stabilized. We will no longer be concerned with solving our own problems, but agents in the more fundamental matrix of the universe. A singing cohesion, unimagined potential, every last thing alive joining in participation in existence, with all matter converted to meaning.